My name is Davita Hobson, and I'm the lead surgical coordinator for the Moore Eye Institute.
Your optometrist has told you you have a cataract. What does that mean? It means that you've had enough birthdays that the natural lens in your eye is no longer functioning properly. Your vision is a little cloudy and a little dull. So here at the Moore Eye Institute, we offer several different opportunities for cataract surgery. We offer both manual or basic cataract surgery, and we offer advanced technology bladeless or laser cataract surgery. The difference between the two procedures is manual cataract surgery is a little bit like your signature. It's something that you've been doing for a long time. You sign a lot of bills and write a lot of checks, and you get very comfortable with doing it. So pretty much every time your signature is almost exactly the same, but the key word is almost. Bladeless cataract surgery or laser-assisted cataract surgery offers more precision and more customization for each individual. It's a smart technology where a laser is programmed to make the specific incisions in the surface of the eye that's needed for cataract surgery. And also it's a little bit of a gentler approach because inside the eye we do use a little bit of laser to kind of soften the cataract so that we minimize any scars on the surface of the eye. Femto laser is advanced smart technology where the surgery is virtually blade free. It's more customizable, more precision, and more gentle. It's a more gentle approach for cataract surgery. Femto laser cataract surgery, because it's advanced smart technology, it can measure the cornea, the surface of the eye, within microns, something that the human eye can't do. So it gives you more precision, more customization. It's a gentler approach. We use less heat in the eye during surgery, and patients tend to have a little less swelling and inflammation postoperatively, so they see better post-op day one, as opposed to manual surgery. Sometimes there's a little swelling and inflammation post-op day one, which unfortunately is something that's associated with surgery. It's something that can't be avoided, but most certainly when we can take a gentler approach, that is an option that we like to offer patients. And your surgeon will determine which option is best for you. Each patient comes in and they're evaluated by the surgeon. The surgeon talks to them a little bit about some of the opportunities that they have for cataract surgery, and you'll be scheduled for a date later to meet with one of our surgical coordinators. At that time, you'll go over all of the different opportunities for cataract surgery. We'll talk to you, answer all of your questions, and explain the different types of procedures, and also talk to you a little bit about what to expect during and after surgery, and what your vision is going to be like following cataract surgery. During cataract surgery, your natural lens is removed, and an artificial lens is implanted in your eye. We now offer several different types of lenses that can be implanted. The basic lens implant is called a monofocal lens, and it gives you one of two types of vision. It either gives you good distance vision or good reading vision. Most people opt for having good distance vision because that's their everyday enjoying life, walking around, watching TV vision. And then there's other lenses that can kind of give you a little more depth in vision that can simulate what your vision might have been like at the age of 20, or for those that have been blessed with good eyesight, it'll simulate what your vision was like probably when you were about 20. The other lenses that we offer are accommodating lenses, multifocal lenses, and we also offer a lens that reduces astigmatism. A multifocal lens, there's a couple different types of multifocal lenses out there. The multifocal lens is designed to sort of mimic your eye's natural vision. It's designed to give you all realms of vision. The three primary realms of vision are distance, intermediate, and near vision. Near vision is basically your reading vision. The multifocal lenses are designed to virtually eliminate or reduce the need for glasses. 94 to 96% of people who have multifocal lenses implanted don't need glasses following cataract surgery. So it's an opportunity to be glasses free. People spend quite a bit of money on glasses over the course of years. We have several patients that come in and say they've just gotten new glasses and then they found out that they had a cataract. And you can spend hundreds of dollars on a pair of glasses, or you can make the investment to get a multifocal lens that can hopefully eliminate the need for glasses altogether. It's an investment in your vision for a lifetime. Another type of lens that we offer here is called an accommodating lens or a crystal lens. A crystal lens is a little bit different than a multifocal lens because it actually moves with your eye. So the crystal lens is designed more closely to mimic your eye's natural lens. And you say the crystal lens is a lot like a multifocal lens, but your surgeon will determine which lens is best for you based on the condition of your eye. The last type of lens that we offer is a toric lens. You may have heard your optometrist talk to you about something called astigmatism. Astigmatism is basically an irregular shape in your cornea. And when your cornea is shaped differently, it changes the way you perceive light. It's kind of like your sharpness in vision. For those of you that have had enough birthdays like I have, I kind of think of an astigmatism. It's like one of those old TVs where you had to kind of twist the knob to sharpen your vision a little bit. So you see well, but sometimes your vision is a little bit hazy or things you can't see clearly with definition. Astigmatism can be corrected surgically with the toric lens. Or it can be corrected with glasses. The toric lens is what we implant to correct the astigmatism, and it's designed to reduce or kind of offset the shape of your cornea so that it can optimize your vision without the use of glasses for distance vision. It doesn't, however, eliminate the need for reading glasses, but it does keep you spectacle free for most of the day and when you're reading things that are a little bit closer to you and you need to see things that are a little more in fine print or details, you would need reading glasses. The lens implants are designed to last a lifetime. Of course, that's given the underlying health of your eye. There's no trauma to the eye. However, at some point after cataract surgery, many people do need a touch-up laser. It's called a YAG laser, where sometimes a little bit of scar tissue does develop over top of this lens. It could happen within 6 months to several years after surgery. Particularly diabetic patients tend to develop this scar tissue a little bit sooner. And there's a laser that can be done in office that kind of clears up some of that scar tissue that forms over the artificial lens implant, and then it clears your vision. So patients will sometimes see that several months or several years after surgery, they're beginning to get a little cloud or a haze. And that simply means that a little scar tissue or a little film has formed over top of this lens and it needs to be removed with a minor laser treatment that's done in the office. It takes just a matter of seconds. It's a very comfortable procedure, but that is something that's involved in the process of cataract surgery postoperatively. You'll have some physical restrictions for about a week after cataract surgery. There are some wounds that are healing on the surface of the eye, and it takes them on average about 4 to 5 days to heal. So we do ask that patients adhere to some physical restrictions for about a week after surgery. There's a shield or bandage that will have you sleep in at bedtime for about a week just to make sure you're not rubbing or bumping in your sleep. And we also restrict any strenuous activities such as heavy lifting or bending. We don't want you to do anything that could result in damage or injury to the face or head. We don't want you to put any pressure on the face or head while these wounds are healing. But most patients can return back to their usual activity within about 2 days. Typically, we have patients take off the day of surgery and the day after, and then as long as you can adhere to some minor physical restrictions and you're not doing anything very strenuous or stressful, you can return back to work. Patients are typically dilated after cataract surgery for about 48 hours. So the day of and the day after surgery are where you have the most difficulty with bright lights and a little bit of blurry vision because of the extensive drops that are used during surgery. So probably in about 2 days, that dilation goes down for most patients and you're able to return to work with limited restrictions.